Hey, everybody, sure. Hi, how are you all?
Doing well.
Good to see you.
Lieutenant Governor, yes. The Washington Post has published a report from a woman who says that you sexually assaulted her back in 2004. What's your response to that allegation?
The allegation is completely false, as was indicated in our statement. And if you read through the story, you'll see it's completely uncorroborated. And the fact that they would run a story on an uncorroborated allegation from now 15 years ago tells you exactly what the smear is all about.
Sure.
So I met her at the convention. We met and talked, and I did not know her prior to. I was 25 years old, unmarried, a campaign staffer at the time, and we hit it off. She was very interested in me, and so eventually at one point we ended up going to my hotel room. This is in 2004. She was, very much into consensual encounter, and she even admits in the story there's consensual activity going on. And again, I have children, so I'm going to be very circumspect about what I say. But everything was 100% consensual. Does anybody think it's any coincidence that on the eve of potentially my being elevated, that that's when this uncorroborated smear comes out? Does anybody believe that's a coincidence? Well, listen, I am the Lieutenant Governor of the Commonwealth of Virginia, elected by 1.36 million Virginians. They put their trust and their faith in me to serve in that role, and I have honored that trust and faith.
Staff members, discussions?
I'm sorry?
With your staffers, with your discussions, what you would do on day one if you are ascended to that position?
Look, like I said, there's a lot of uncertainty right now in our government, but we always have to be prepared to assume our roles and responsibilities that are given to us by the Virginia Constitution. This is not something that anyone formulated in terms of how this process proceeds. And so we are prepared and we'll continue to be prepared.
But
God bless you.
About the interview.